Let's go now to the home menu. Then we go to settings and we have a look at the accessories. Now we are going to make a controller setup. We can here adjust the vibration intensity. When we are using the microphone on our controller, the intensity is set to weak. If we use a headset or we mute the microphone with that button here, here's a button you can see, I can push. The intensity select here will be applied, okay? So we can now choose the vibration intensity, strong, medium, weak, or off if you like. But I think strong is the best the choose thing there. We have now the trigger effect intensity. It's the same like before, strong, medium, weak, or off. That is the trigger in effect intensity. Brightness of the controller indicators. These are the colors here. We can dim it or we can brighten it more. And we adjust the brightness of the indicators on our wireless controller or, of course, of the DualShock 4. If we select other than bright standard, the indicators may not be bright enough for some games and apps. The indicator will bright regardless of this setting and situation where the PlayStation camera needs to recognize them. Okay. Then communication method. We use Bluetooth or we can use a USB cable. The USB cable is a USB-C cable, which you can dock on the console on USB-A and USB-C or USB-A. And then you can dock it on the controller. Then we have the wireless controller device software, the controller speak volume. We can adjust it here. You can hear it. The volume level, shortcut for the create button. The create button can have a shortcut. For example, here. We press once, we display the create controls, we press and hold, we take a screenshot, and we press twice, we save a video clip. We can make a length of the recent gameplay video clip 30 seconds, or we can gain it up to 1 hour. This will save confirmations on the screenshot. If you like it, you can choose it. Then game presets. Here we can make a preset for each game, okay? Here you can see I need the easiest way and the resolution mode. Then the controllers is here, vibration intensity and trigger effect intensity. It's the same like before. You can see these are nearly all options from or for your controller, which you can use. And the controller is really awesome to navigate. We have in nearly all games is X, the action button, to jump or to make something and to enter something or as well. The O button or the pizza button is go back. The pizza box button or the left button here is to make a random thing. The triangle button is another optional thing in games. And then we have here is the button for is like a start button. And here is the select button to take screenshot of the video clip. Of course, here we can navigate via, for example, weapons or other devices in the game. And of course, here on the left stick, we can move. On the right is most of the time in the games is to look. We can push on them too. And of course, here is a touchpad. And here, of course, here is the possibility of the trigger and bumper buttons. Most time is to aim with the left and fire with the right side triggers. That's easy and it is nice to use. This is the DualSense controller for your PlayStation 5. You can see I can switch between the menus by using the X button. To go back is the O button. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe me and give me a positive feedback. I hope to see you again on my channel. Soon.